I didn't have any dealings with the Russians except for his lawyer, Anatoly Kucherina, who invited me to meet him. And he had written a book, which we used in the movie, when we adapted in the movie, called Time of the Octopus. My dealings, he was always very courteous and arranged meetings either in his lawyer's office or in hotels, secure places. And we brought Joe over on one visit, and Kieran Fitzgerald accompanied me on 3 or 4 visits. So I would say that Mr. Snowden has been highly critical of the Russian state because of their recent surveillance legislation, which is a surprise to many people. It's a harsh legislation, somewhat akin to the American legislation that exists, but the Americans don't say it, obviously, as straightforwardly as some of the Russians do. The Russians do believe in legislation. The law is very sacred to them, although we may not agree on the interpretation of it. As to, you have to recognize that it was Russia that gave him asylum. There's no denying this, and they were, and in some sense, who knows, the State Department did revoke his passport while he was in the air. So perhaps, as some people think, perhaps this was planned, but perhaps it was probably not, you know. And it was a screw-up by the State Department, let's say. So they're the only country in the world that probably can protect him. China did not want to step into that issue, neither did the other countries that were asked for asylum. Everyone seemed to be scared of the United States. We saw that when the president of Bolivia's plane was forced down in Austria. As I said many times, when I was a young man, I believe he would have had asylum in places like Switzerland, France, Sweden, Canada, even. There was a good chance of that. But things have changed. It's more of an American world now.